Hello guys, this is Om Dwivedi, welcomes you all in our Didami IAS, and today we are going to discuss about the one of the most dynamic topic of UPSC, that is science and technology. In this lecture, we will mainly focus for the main syllabus and also discuss the strategy. And for prelims, we will have a separate video, but we will try to connect the pre-syllabus with the main syllabus so you can easily prioritize and club the syllabus of both pre as well as for the mains. Now let's start our discussion. Friends, generally S&T is considered as a tough topic among students, and many a times it seems that students skip this topic. But let me tell you that it is almost impossible to clear the mains without the S&T. We'll talk about it further, that why is it so, and in case of S&T, when the whole world is moving towards the technology, then UPSC also demands for the scientific temperament in the officers. This is the reason UPSC is continuously changing the pattern, as in 2011 they had changed the pattern of prelims, and in 2013 also changes were seen in the main syllabus. And in both the changes, S&T was made more dynamic as well as more elaborative. If we talk about the syllabus, then some topics we can directly see from the notification, but holistic coverage will be covered with the previous year questions. Friends, this is our detailed discussion video in which you came to know about all ins and outs. But before that, let's see what all things we are going to discuss in this video. The first one is importance and marks weightage. Second, we will see syllabus, then areas and the question they are asking, then the prelims portion little bit, then mains portion, and what to read and from where to read. Then we will see how to do practice, and the last one, what not to do. So guys, if we see about the scheme of the exam, then in prelims you will see in the notification that only general science is mentioned, and from this portion 12 to 15 questions they generally ask, which can be said that they are the pure science questions. But the concept of science can be used in solving some geography question as well as some environment questions. When we club all those three, then the number of questions are approx 50 questions, which is 50%. Okay. And if we talk about the mains, then the S&T portion comes in the paper 3, and there we see approx 3 to 5 questions every year, which consists of 40 to 60 marks. So we can say that it has a very much importance in mains. And let me tell you one more importance of science and technology, that is, science and technology cannot be separated in paper 1, paper 2, paper 4, and also in the essay paper. How is it so? Let's see. If we talk about science and tech plus paper 1, then geography and environment is a part of paper 1. In this portion also, science section is asked, like IRNSS they had asked earlier. And if we talk about science and tech plus paper 2, mainly this portion we study polity and governance, and here there are many plans and policies of the government related to science and technology, for which acts are made and they merged with the line of S&T. For example, DNA technology regulation bill, surrogacy regulation bill. So this type of question can be asked in paper 2 as well as in paper 3. Also Aadhaar, in which the use of biometrics is there, and many security related issues are there, can be asked in S&T as well as in paper 2. And if we see the connection of S&T in paper 4, here in ethics paper, some case studies can be there which can be dependent on the scientific temperament of the daily life. For example, one can make a case study over ultrasonography for sex determination of fetus. So ultrasonography can be banned. If banned, then many different diseases can be hampered, and if not, doctor can misuse it. For this type of ethical dilemma, you cannot answer the proper answer without the interference of the science and technology. And in essay paper also contain one essay from the science and technology portion. And if you have a command in science and technology portion, then you choose this essay and you can have lead over there. Now let's move ahead And first of all, we'll see about the syllabus of prelims. Although this class is mainly focused on the mains, but still we will have a short discussion over prelims and try to create a connection with the mains exam. About the prelim syllabus, UPSC has just written two words, that is general science, and we can't decipher anything just from these two words. So we have to read the previous year questions for 5 years and identify the topics. Many people just say that for pre you just have to read 6 to 10 NCERT, but no, you have to understand that we are living in a 21st century and continuously we are going from developing to developed nation, and technical development are so fast that areas of general science has become so much vast. So I had simplified the syllabus with the help of previous year questions for you, and here's the syllabus: physics, chemistry, biology, human health, basic understanding of new technology, energy science and technology, environment and geography related science. You have to prepare these topics to get through prelims. As you know that this lecture is a mains oriented lecture, so we will not go into the full details, but we will try to connect them in next 1 or 2 minutes, and for this I will put the most important topic from the list, that is basic understanding of new technology, and try to link it. Actually, here's a catch, that is details of this topic we will get from the syllabus of mains. And the main areas of the mains are the biotechnology, nanotechnology, space technology and the ICT. You just need to know the basic concept and current development related to these topics, because in prelims, suppose UPSC is asking for 15 questions from S&T, then 12 questions will be from this portion. Now let's talk about the mains. First of all, let me read the syllabus for you. These are the 3 points that has been given by the UPSC as a mains syllabus of science and technology. First one is science and technology development and their application and effect in everyday life. Second, achievement of Indians in science and technology, indigenization of technology and developing new technology. And the third one is awareness in the field of IT, space, computers, robotics and nanotechnology, biotechnology and issues relating to the intellectual property rights. When we read this, overall we are getting the syllabus, but we are not getting anything sequentially in a point form. And the other thing is that to get the holistic syllabus, we need to see the previous year questions so that you can get the whole things in points form, which I had done for you, that is biotechnology, nanotechnology, robotics and artificial intelligence, space technology, ICT, computer technology, IPR issue, Indian scientist, defense technology, nuclear technology, energy technology and the transport technology. In these last 4 points, defense technology, nuclear technology, energy technology and the transport technology are not mentioned in the syllabus anywhere. And other 8 points are either mentioned directly or indirectly in the syllabus. If you say that where is everyday life related to the topic, then ICT and computer technology and transport technology are the direct topics. And also in the corona periods, we noticed that with the help of Arogya Setu, we can detect the corona chain. So this is a type of artificial intelligence. So if we talk about some questions, then let's first talk about biotechnology. 2017 question is from stem cell. 2018 question is from biopharma. These are the questions based on the basic concepts. And if you are not properly aware about these concepts, then you can't answer these questions. Also, some questions are understanding based, like how can biotechnology help to improve the living standard of the farmer. This is UPSC 19 question. And if we talk about the space technology, then benefit of our space program was asked in 2019, and in 2017 manned space mission was asked. Question was asked in IRNSS. Means many questions were asked from this portion. Now from IPR, normally IPR related questions they ask from biotech. In 2019 the question is asked that how is the government of India protecting traditional knowledge of medicine from patenting by pharmaceutical companies. Now from the topic Indian scientist, in 2018 they have asked the question from the Bose-Einstein statics, and in 2019 they have asked about the contribution of M. Vishwasaraya and the M.S. Swaminathan. So from 2018 this UPSC is focusing about recognized Indian scientist. I think overall there are 20 to 22 scientists which we need to study. Then from nuclear technology, they had asked from fast breeder reactor program in 2019, nuclear energy program in 2018. Means UPSC is asking the questions from all these fields. So these topics should always be in your mind, that whenever and wherever you see the any article related to these topics, you don't ignore that. Now let's move ahead to approach of UPSC mains, which can be called 5-point strategy, that is basic concept, application, ELSI, that is ethical, legal and social issue. Fourth one is development in India and world, and the fifth one is current developments and trends. This is the most important part of our preparation. If we will be able to follow this religiously, then science and tech will be a cakewalk. For example, let's talk about any topic like nanotechnology. We should know about the basic concept of nanotechnology, in that we should know about nanoscale, nanomaterial such as graphene, fullerene, carbon nanotubes, silver nanotubes, platinum nanotubes. Then we should know about the principles of nanotechnology and the methods of nanotechnology. We will not get the direct questions from this concept, but it's the key to prelims. Yes, this is the thing which I had talked earlier about the connection of pre and mains. Now let's come to the application part of nanotechnology, that is in the field of health, environment, energy, security, agriculture, electronics, etc. etc. And in ELSI, we can write about health issues, social issues, economic issues, environmental issues related to nanotechnology. Here on the basis of social justice, we will see that how the government and the other agencies will ensure equality in different classes, like not only the rich can get all the benefits. Now if we talk about the development in India of nanoscience, then they had started a nanoscience and technology initiative. Then we started nano mission, nano park, etc. Means we will talk about the government plans and policies. Also we will take care about the world level. And finally, try to link all these issues with the current trends. If you will be able to explain these 5 points in every topic sequentially, then nothing will be left. Now let's talk about the study material for which many of you are eagerly waiting. But let me tell you, no book of science and technology is available in the market. You just have to study NCERT from 6th to 10th, mains class notes, doesn't matter from where you had done the classes. You just have to revise the notes again and again. If you have not done the classes from anywhere, then in Didami IAS, we will do the classes for mains 2020 and try to cover the whole S&T here only. Then the newspaper. Please, please, please do follow this newspaper, because the exact current affairs from where you can attempt in a most simple language is from the newspaper only. Then you have to follow Yojana and the Science Reporter. Science Reporter is the only magazine which is fully dedicated only for the science and technology portion. Then internet. From internet I mean to say is that you just need to see the technical terms. Then the question practice. More you do the question paper, more you will get the conceptual clarity. Then the discussion. Discussion means group discussion. If you are having a group of 2 to 3 people, then you can discuss some topics on the daily basis or on the weekly basis. And also you can do the discussion in Didamic IAS platform. Then let's see the do's and don'ts. You have to practice the questions on the daily basis. Revise again and again. You have to do the 3 revision at least. One, the day when you study. Second revision, just very next day. And the third revision on a weekly basis. If you are doing this, then you are sending the information in a permanent memory. And please do regularly update yourself. And what you should not do is, you should not blindly follow any guidebook and limit yourself. You should know that much only which you need in the exam. You should not mug up the unnecessary data, or you should not go into the details. which generally we doesn't require. So limit yourself, okay? So that's the strategy from my side, and I ensure that this strategy works for science and technology. Thank you so much.